In this tutorial, I'm going to cover how to export images from or layers from Substance Painter with opacity or transparency. For example, if you're familiar with PNGs and PSDs, you can export them so you have color information like this flag here that I did, or this flag decal, and you can export it so that it's something like this. You have nothing in the background, it is pure transparent, and you have this color information floating on top. That, of course, is because you have alpha right here, the magic of alpha channels, okay? Alpha channels means black, means the pixels don't show up. White means the pixels do show up, and gray, something in between, means they kind of show up. That's our alpha channel, okay? And when you have all the RGB stuff on top of it, you get the red, the green, and the blue, you get the color information, and you get a transparent background, okay? That's the basic rundown there. And I want to have something like this as a result, what I export out of Substance Painter. For example, I made these simple swatches of color here, but these could just as easily be a smart material of wood and copper and gold, or you know, bubbling tree sap. It doesn't matter what goes in here. These, or it could be 20 different layers, okay? But you want to just export out, like say in this instance, just your cool, neato painting layers that you've been doing here with all their nifty effects, and you want the color information, let's say, with an alpha channel attached to it, okay, going along for the ride. So how do we do that? Let's go ahead and hide our flag for right now, and I have these simple layers here, just color fill layers with black as their, with their mask, just black masks attached. Go over to texture set settings. Go down here, you'll see the texture sets that we have available. There are five of them by default: base color, height, roughness, metallic, and normal. The metallic and roughness and height are all grayscale information, okay? They don't have RGB information in them. So and opacity is really no different. If we click here and create our new material channel, these are called material channels, just to, for the sake of clarity, these are material channels. I'm going to create opacity as a new material channel. So here they are. That's different. It uses the same word from a RGB or color channel. Okay, there's my red and turning it on and off, my green and my blue. These are color channels. These are material channels. Okay, there are holes that you fill stuff up with in Substance Painter. Okay, that's Substance Painter's term for them. So I have an opacity material channel here. It's grayscale information, just like height and color. I can demonstrate that. Let's go ahead and go down to our little red layer here, click on that, and actually let's click on the mask next to it, and you can see if we paint into that mask, I'm going to use the brush here and make sure we have our grayscale, because this is a grayscale image. It's going to be black or white that gets painted in there. I'm going to turn it all the way white, and if I draw onto his little chest here, hi, there it is. Okay, you can see here what's showing up is color information by itself there, height information, there it is, and opacity information. But if I turn it on and off, you don't see it. The reason for that is this: just because it's a material channel doesn't mean you're going to necessarily see stuff in here. Sometimes game engines and other things need to deal with all manner of material challenge, material information that you won't necessarily, you want to create and author it in Substance Painter, but it might not show up in your viewport. That maybe sounds confusing, but it'll make sense in just a bit. I want this opacity information to be part of my exported texture so that it has an alpha channel with all my high, my little color information here. We can visualize what each of these different material channels look like, of course, by going up here in the 3D viewport or in the 2D viewport. I'm gonna go right here. Go down to base color. Now we're focusing on simply just this color information here, okay? Just to make it a little bit more clear, because this will come in later, let's go below the color layer. Let's create another layer here and call, and let's make it just color information and make it dark blue, okay? As you can see, we have this red that's floating on top of this fill. This one has no mask, which is just filling up the entire texture space with this dark blue. The red on top of it is confined to where the pixels in the mask, you can look at the mask by holding down Alt and clicking on the mask swatch here. You can see everything black means there's no red gonna show up. Everything brighter or whiter than black, gray, red, you know, full white, whatever, that means more red showing up. Okay, if I click back over here, the black areas in the mask are hidden, the white areas are visible. Okay, that's in our color layer. If I hide this backdrop of blue, you get this checkerboard. It means that there's no other color RGB base color information in this document that is currently visible. Okay, there's nothing else. So sometimes you might want to create a, let's say if you're making a pair of blue jeans, you might create a kind of a grayish dull blue color as a fill layer to start with. And on top of that, you add things like rips and tears or whatever you're going to do. So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this blue fill layer here. And we're just back to this with this checkerboard information. Now, let's switch. Now, we looked at our color information. Let's go back here to our red swatch here. Let's go look at our height information. You can see here it's just grayscale info. You can barely see it, but because it has nothing below it, the height information is dictated by this little slider here. Okay? You can see I can change it as I drag it up. I'm going to just put it kind of a medium gray. And let's switch from height over here to opacity. And opacity, just the same. It has nothing in its backdrop. I haven't created a base opacity. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that now, because if I export this opacity here, it's not going to show up. So above flag here, I'm going to create a brand new layer and just call that base opacity. I'm going to disable everything but opacity by holding down Alt and clicking on the opacity material channel. And I'm going to drag this. I want this to be transparent. This is visible or opaque. This is invisible or transparent. Okay. So now, hide this. It is filling this entire texture with transparency. Think of it like that. If I filled it here, it's kind of a somewhat translucency, and if I fill it up to here, it's 100% opacity, no transparency. I want to fill it up with full transparency as a base kind of a base layer here of my opacity. On top of that, I have my little red layer there, and I'm going to go ahead and go into my little purple one here and click on the mask. Okay, and we're viewing opacity, we're not viewing the mask. I'm going to go ahead and shrink this down a little bit. I'm going to make a nice little box around my high in the purple, and I'm going to do the same thing with the mask in the green. Make a little mouse art here, and there it is. So there's my opacity channel. I've been painting it, and the reason, let's go back out to material layer, and this is what we would expect. Our green layer has color, height, and opacity enabled. Our purple layer, color, height, and opacity. Our red layer, color, height, and opacity. And our base opacity layer, we don't mess with this stuff. All we want is just a base black opacity, okay? And everywhere that you paint something white in this mask, it makes this layer's opacity fill it up, okay? It'll make sense in a minute. It doesn't just yet. But here's what I have. I have my color information, base color, height, and opacity, okay? Go to material here. Now, so we have all this set up so far. How do we get it out as a texture? Make sure you have base opacity, this layer underneath. If you don't have it full of black opacity, it's not gonna export it. That said, go to File, Export Textures, or Control Shift E. Now what we're gonna do here is create a new output template, because we wanna make sure we just get out this base color with I don't care about height right now. I just wanna go with base color and opacity. So we have this cool, nifty, sort of effect like this, okay, where you have an RGBA texture. So what we can do then is we're going to create a new output template, brand new. We're going to double click on here and call it opacity only, whatever, okay, not a very original name. So now we're going to create our output, what output maps are going to get exported with our texture, okay, when we use this preset. What we're going to do here is we're going to create an RGBA. And RGBA just means it has red, green, blue information. That's this color stuff here. Okay. You can put anything in there. You can put that's color, base color. You can put world space normal, normal maps. It doesn't matter. Any color information that has red and green and blue in it, okay, you can put in here. But we're going to go ahead and just grab base color and drag it in here. That means we're going to get, you want our RGB information. Now, it's piped into here, this base color information. I'm gonna go ahead and go out of it for just a second, hit save settings. What it means is this base color information that's in this material channel, this material channel, okay, that is getting funneled, it's getting piped or broadcast into in our output template here, opacity only, there it is. That means this base color information is getting broadcast into this little output slot. It's the Substance Painter is going to take whatever you put in here, and that's going to be your exported texture. Okay, so anyway, so then we have our alpha information. Now you would think you just grab base color, because I saw this earlier, drag it into the alpha, and you would pick the A channel, right? Because this alpha, you know, seems to be showing up here. There's nothing there to go out in the base color. The base color, this transparency that we want, this opacity rather, does not live in the base color. Okay, it lives down here in opacity. Now, that seems a little confusing, but it's no different from if I were to put a normal map in there, okay, RGB. This normal map doesn't have alpha information, okay? At least currently it doesn't. And if I were to grab here, all it's gonna do is just fill it full of white if I were to do this, all right? It's not gonna give us anything. It's gonna give us very unhelpful information. So I'm gonna go back to base color, drag it into our RGB, choose the funnel out into it, the RGB information. And this alpha information, I'm going to go to opacity and drag it here and let it go and click the gray channel. Now, why the gray channel and not the A channel? It's quite simple. It's if I can, this is just a grayscale image. That's all this is. It's a simple grayscale image. I can put emissive into there if I want, or glossiness or height or metallic. These are all grayscale images. I can drag them in there. And they don't possess any alpha channel information. They possess grayscale information, okay? This is just a source, and this is your target, all right? I don't want metallic information in there. I want opacity information in there. And so I want the grayscale information that is currently being stored in my opacity channel, okay? So there it is. There's my opacity grayscale information, my base color RGB information. I'm gonna go ahead and hit settings and just save and control shift E to bring it up, just because I'm, you know, OCD or something, and I wanted to make sure and have that information saved. So let's go ahead and save settings, make sure everything looks great. There's my base opacity. There it is. Okay, it has black and it has the white opacity stuff on top. And we're going to go ahead and control shift E and export it. Oh, make sure it's going to our desktop. And also, we got to make sure and change our output template. We want to use opacity only, because now we're actually going to use these nifty things that I just made right here. And oh, finally, we want to make sure our padding here is turned to dilation plus transparent. Okay, that just keeps it from smearing color all the way outside the boundaries of our UV space, of our UV islands rather. Okay, keep fingers crossed. Let's see what happens. Export it. Okay, and open our output directory. Look at that. I'm gonna open this up into my texture editor here, and there it is. There is our transparent information here, our drawing, our color information, and just to prove that I got it right, look at that. That's our alpha channel, our alpha color channel, all right? Let's turn it back on again, the color information. It looks just as nifty and spiffy as our little flag here. Now that I have this here, I can take this RGB information. It's a texture now. I can do whatever I want with it. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and save settings, get out of this. I'm going to create a new fill layer. Okay. And I'm going to turn off the, I'm going to hide it for right now. And just to show you how cool it is, you can go ahead and hit import resources. Add some resources. I want to go back to the texture I just made and hit open, define it as a texture, put it on our project shelf and import it. And here it is in our project shelf. Sorry, there's going to be here somewhere. There it is. Okay. I go to my fill layer. I want just color information, and I'm going to drag it into my base color little slot there. Okay, it doesn't seem like anything happened because it didn't make it visible again. That's cool. Now, this is where it gets kind of fun. I'm going to hit Q to make this transform gizmo. This is the new nifty base color. This is my flat texture right here. Okay, I exported it as a little decal. So what's cool about this is you can make a cool looking piece of a texture that you really dig and have like rough edges around it so it fades out or something like that. And you can then put it on top of something else. Like, let's say there's bullet holes or something like that. You can create a whole bunch of bullet holes in Substance Designer, Substance Painter, and everything, export them out with an alpha channel around them. And it has alpha information and color information combined. Okay, and you can take that information and you can, there we go, move it around, place it, scale it, whatever you see fit. I'm putting it on his back here. And as you look around, there he is, yay. I don't know what's gonna happen if I put hide information in there. Maybe nothing, probably nothing right now because there's no inherent height information in this texture. It's just a flat texture. But there's ways of, you know, doing that, which I'm not going to cover by this video. All right, that about wraps this up. If you go ahead and create in your texture set settings, create a opacity channel right here by hitting the plus button, go into your layers, every layer that you have content that you want to be in that opacity export or that bitmap with an alpha channel, you simply have to have all of these things where your color, your height, whatever is enabled, but make sure opacity is enabled as well or it won't show up, okay? Have that in all the layers that you want. Control-Shift-E, you export your output template, should have RGB information for whatever color texture or whatever you're doing here, your alpha information, drag your whatever color information you need here. And you can also just set it out as a grayscale too if you wanted to, just a grayscale image. You can just drag opacity directly into there from the gray channel. And if you then export it, you're going to get a black and white image that looks, cancel, that looks just like this. It'll look like this. This is what your image will look like if you just want the grayscale image for your alpha. However you want to do it, you can pack it how you want. All right, that's it. I hope this helps. Thanks.